After I ruined your childhood by telling you guys that all your favorite dinosaurs have a likelihood that they possess feathers, and that feathers in dinosaurs might have been as common and as diversified as hair in mammals, opening you up to a world of quilled Carnotaurus, owl-faced therizinosaurs, mohawk sauropods, maned allosaurs, and my personal favorite, Trihipterixes, Spinosaurus with whiskers. Let's take a break from all that controversial stuff and talk about sharks. Sharks are pretty cool. They're arguably some of the most terrifying creatures ever to swim the seas. And considering sharks have survived countless mass extinctions, ranging from the one that killed the dinosaurs, to the one that caused the extinction of 90% of all life, sharks are perfect killing machines and survivors. One of the largest recorded great whites was caught on film recently, but this guy would be dwarfed by one of the most feared sharks that ever swam the oceans. Megalodon. Yes, the Megalodon. One of the most overhyped prehistoric creatures, probably surpassing T-Rex in popularity. Megalodon was a giant shark that swam the ocean seas from 15 million BC to 2.6 million BC, meaning Megalodon never met the dinosaurs. The last megalodons probably died out around the same time the first evolutionary seeds of humanity began in Australopithecus. The name Megalodon means mighty or big tooth, and there's no question why. The remains we have of this great beast are its teeth, which can measure to at least 7 inches long, some teeth ranging 7.6 inches long, dwarfing some of the largest great white's teeth. Using Megalodon's teeth, paleontologists calculate that Megalodon was between 52 to 56 feet long. It is highly possible that some Megalodons could have reached a mind-boggling 60 feet long. Meaning, some Megalodons could have reached more than half the size of the largest blue whales. Megalodon possessed a dorsal fin as tall as a man, and jaws that could swallow a person whole. Megalodon was truly a real-life Jaws. Actually, the shark from the movie Jaws was just 25 feet long, meaning Megalodon would still dwarf Jaws. This is one of the times where science is actually scarier than fiction. Scientists believe Megalodon roamed all around the world, due to the oceans being much warmer and more hospitable for sharks before the Ice Age. Megalodon was the king of the prehistoric oceans, and this king was a killer. Able to swim at extremely high speeds, growing to enormous sizes, and possessing a killer bite, Megalodon was a super predator, and probably was the most fearsome and aggressive creature to ever have existed. Fossil evidence shows us that Megalodon ate pretty much everything that moved. The vertebrae of whales have been discovered with deep gashes made by a gigantic slaughterer. Megalodon ate dolphins, large whales like sperm whales and bowhead whales, porpoises, giant sea turtles, a strange prehistoric aquatic mammal, Odobenoctetops, and prehistoric giant aquatic sloths. Megalodon likely also had a tendency for cannibalism. Odds are, Megalodon attacked its victims the same way modern great white sharks attack theirs, by diving deep underwater and ambushing their prey from below with great power and energy. This attack would stun its victims, allowing Megalodon to finish them off. Megalodon's predatory reign lasted for a baffling 13 million years. As the climate got colder and the Ice Age began, Megalodon's prey began to die out, as well as travel to colder climates. To add to this, some of Megalodon's mammalian prey became predators themselves, as Megalodon probably often ran into competition for prey items with large predatory sperm whales, like Leviathan. A combination of these events would eventually kill off this terrifying creature, leaving the oceans free of any super predator exceeding 30 feet long. Megalodon has been featured multiple times in pop culture, probably most famously in the documentary series Chased by Sea Monsters, in which a man, Nigel Marvin, is lowered into a shark cage as a Megalodon frenzies. The episode brings us some of the most terrifying visuals ever put to film. Megalodon was also featured in the quote-unquote documentary Mermaids: The Body Found, where a megalodon is seen attacking a mermaid millions of years after Megalodon was extinct. Megalodon was also featured in the shamefully fake Megalodon: The Monster Shark Lives, in which a megalodon is proposed to still be alive today. This hour-long program is filled with lies, deception, and bad photoshopped images. Scientists know for a fact Megalodon went extinct 2.6 million years ago. If Megalodon is still alive today, it would completely destroy the fossil record and change all we know about prehistoric life. It is impossible for Megalodon to have survived the mass extinction during the Ice Age, and leave no fossilized evidence of its existence for 2.6 million years. All of the evidence proposed in the Shark Week special was painfully fake and made up, hiring paid actors to pose as scientists. Well, that concludes this episode of Prehistoric Profile. If you like what you see, what's this? You want me to do a prehistoric battle with Megalodon and Liplerodon? Alright, you asked for it. Before we start the battle, let's just show these creatures side by side and to scale. Wait, what's this? Liplerodon is really small? Yeah, this is a common misconception. Liplerodon was a prehistoric aquatic reptile that lived during the Jurassic period. Liplerodon was greatly exaggerated in size in the 1999 documentary, Walking with Dinosaurs.
Surprise, motherfucker!
The documentary featured Liplerodon as a 25 meter or 82 foot long predator, when in reality the largest known specimen was a little over 10 meters or 33 feet long. And most Liplerodons had a more typical size range from 5 to 7 meters or 16 to 23 feet long. A very far cry from the Goliath seen in The Walking with Dinosaurs. If Megalodon met Liplerodon, hey that rhymes, clearly Megalodon would win. Most likely mistaking Liplerodon as an oversized seal. Now, if Megalodon met the fictionalized Walking with Dinosaurs Liplerodon, yes, Liplerodon would most likely win. Alright, that concludes today's Paleo Profile. If you like what you see, like and subscribe for all things prehistoric. Thanks,